Dr. Dinesh Nayak. I'm the director of neurology at the Glen Eagles Global Health City in Chennai. I'm also an epileptologist. Today we are going to discuss a little bit about epilepsy and epileptic seizures. So let me start off with what is actually an epileptic seizure in the first place. We have to have some basic idea about it. It is nothing but a sudden electrical storm in the brain, which can affect either a small region in the brain or a large portion of the brain. The first thing to do is actually not to panic, because once it has started, there's very little you can actually do to prevent it from further going on. So that's the first thing to do. So first is not to panic. Second thing is, after the patient has actually fallen down, and if you are in the position where the person is in the process of falling down, you can probably hold the patient down. And then once the patient has actually fallen off, then it is important to remove any obstacles nearby. Say, for example, if there's some piece of furniture nearby, like a chair or a table, it's important to remove them from that source. And then keep something soft under the head so that, you know, they don't hurt as much. But then the most important thing that one should not do during the active phase of a tonic-clonic seizure is actually to try and restrain them. Many times what we do is in our anxiety to prevent the person from actually jerking, we try to pin them down by holding their arms and legs. That is never to be done, because by doing that, actually there is the chances of fracturing the limb, the hand or the leg, is very high. So one should never do that. The other important thing to do actually is to time. You know, you have to look at the watch and start seeing the time. The reason why I'm telling this is because it's most of these general 99% of these generalized tonic-clonic seizures stop by 1.5 to maximum 2 minutes. It is extremely unusual for a generalized tonic-clonic seizure to go beyond 2 minutes. Once the seizure stops, once the patient stops having a generalized tonic-clonic seizure, that is the time when we have to act. What is important to do is that one should never restrain the person from having during the tonic-clonic phase or during the jerking phase. But as soon as the jerking ends, which usually is at about 1.5 to 2 minutes, one has to then, at that point in time, turn the person to either the right or the left side, what is called a recovery position. This is most crucial. You should never allow the person to lie down flat. And then what has to be done is allow the secretions, because there's a lot of saliva as well as secretions that is collected in the mouth. And by turning to one side, you allow the secretions that have been accumulated to come out of the mouth. So that is the most important point. Second point is, one must actually observe, see whether the tongue is visible or not. If the tongue is not visible, you can actually put your finger into the mouth and then bring out the tongue, because the tongue can sometimes fall backwards. There's no chance of the tongue being swallowed inside. It never happens. Sometimes people think that the tongue can be swallowed. That never happens. But the tongue can actually fall backwards, and that makes the breathing difficult, and that's all is done. So, and you keep this position. And then keep asking questions, keep trying to make the patient become more awake. And in the next 1 or 2 minutes, generally the person starts becoming awake, and he may not respond, he may be confused, and it takes another 1 or 2 minutes for the person to start recognizing what is happening around. They may not remember what actually happened to them, but they'll be able to start recognizing what has happened around. And until that time, one must keep them in this position. The next thing that one should never do is that as soon as the person becomes a little alert and little awake, but still a bit confused, never put anything into the mouth. The first thing to do is to remove everything from the mouth. Never give any liquid or fluid or juice or water. Nothing should be given through the mouth. Nothing ever should be put into the mouth. So that's the most important second point, which should be avoided. And then slowly, only when you think that the person is fully aware of what is happening, is able to tell his or her name, that is the time then you can make the person to sit up. And moment that happens, only after that, when the person is fully aware and conscious, that's the time when you can give some kind of, you know, liquid or some light meal. That's the time when you have to. So this is in a nutshell the first aid measures, the do's and don'ts of patients who have epileptic seizures. What do you have to do, what you should not do. So thank you very much for your patient listening as well as viewing. And should you have any doubts or any further questions, please feel free to contact us. Thank you very much.